Hello everybody, and welcome to another episode of Olympuscraft SMP. So, I wasn't intending to record an episode today, but I came on this morning, and this happened. So I have Steercat's head because I discovered a little something inside my home, or rather in the walls of my home, that not only cost me an ally, but an entire stack of diamonds. So, I'm going to show you guys my little discovery and unintended consequences. I guess Steercat got me back. Just to get these free doors, though. Alright, so Steercat's up there, AFK. Let's just slide you right out of this box. Bye-bye. That was accidental. I was trying to just push her a little towards the wall so I could put her in a box, but, well, she's up to 5 deaths now. Nevertheless, I am very sorry. I only meant to disorient and confuse, not slaughter. So, all her stuff is in here, keeping the trophy though. And a stack of diamonds for all your trouble, because I feel bad. So yeah, Steercat died. The only problem is that after all of that occurred, I figured out that it wasn't even Steercat who pranked me. It was Code, and Code was told to do it by Rob. So there's a whole chain of people involved in this little shenanigan behind the wall here, and we will not stand for this. So today we will be pranking everybody. And by everybody, I mean the shopping district, because, you know Code, he's never around, so we can't really prank him. Steercat already covered his house in cobwebs. Rob, he claims he's not directly responsible, so we're just gonna take it out on the entire shopping district. We're going to do that by doing a prank that I did back on the Unknown Empire, which is covering the entire place in snow. So, I have a bunch of pumpkins, and I have those snow blocks that I bought last episode and never got around to using. So, I am going to go spawn an army of snowmen and cover the entire shopping district in snow. And there shall be no midget baby villagers to stop me this time. And you know what? I'm gonna take our little canine friend here, because he got lost while I was traveling around the Nether. But I found him, still doesn't have a name, but we're gonna take him along for this journey and bring an early winter to Olympuscraft. Okay, so the dog decided to take a bit of a detour and visit Ellie instead. Doesn't look like she's here though, so we can operate in secrecy. We don't want to be caught. Alright, so the shopping district is directly down there. So we're gonna go plant some snowmen down there, and then we're gonna go find Rob's big disc in the sky and put some more snow in there. So let's just... Oh wow, there's an invasion going on. Alright, so we seem to have a bit of an invasion on our hands. Oh, we need the rain to stop before our army comes in. Attack dog! Yes! Beautiful. Nice. We got more crossbows. We have a pillager's head, another ominous banner. Alright, well, we need to get rid of this rain somehow. But just to make sure nobody knows it's me, we're gonna pass the blame to Steercat once more. In the meantime, though, We're going to buy some more ice because I don't think this is going to be enough. So we're going to get some more of the frozen custard here. Let's get a couple more stacks of that. Let's see, ice cream, powdered snow. Oh, look at all these flavors. Chocolate, vanilla. There's a mystery flavor in here. Interesting. I wonder if it's snow flavored. Blue ice, that might be nice to have. Packed ice, probably a better deal. Uh-oh, you guys. I found Ellie over there. Maybe we should employ some scare tactics. Get her to leave the zone. Boom. She doesn't need to know. Oh no, I forgot the dog's gonna be mad now. Alright everybody, it worked. Ellie is gone, and the skies are clear. So now, we shall cover the shopping district in snow. So we'll make our snowmen first. We'll just put these around the perimeter. Hopefully they cover a nice bit with snow. And then we can manually fill in the rest. So Ellie's got a new game of sorts. Don't really know how to play it, but we'll make sure we leave a snowman or two inside Rob's new shop. Look how fancy it is. You know what it really needs? It's a nice cold touch. We'll just line up a whole army of snowmen right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There we go. Looks as though the winter war zone is coming along nicely. I think one of them even climbed up here. So I think we will put some of the snow and ice inside the nice bookshop right here, because it just looks so nice, but it could be nicer. What better way to decorate than with some of my Polarctic charm? Here we go. Make this one nice and slippery. Is this where the Frostwalker book is? Ah, look at that, it is. Well, make it the frostiest walk you've ever seen. I think we need to pay Evett's shop another visit. Get some more ice. Get some of the Italian ice going in here. We have one diamond left. Why don't we get some blue with this last diamond? There we go. Don't worry, we'll save the good stuff for code. But Rob, I'm gonna give him the cold shoulder as well. That way, next time he beats someone in the Thunderdome, he can give them a bit of a suggestion as to who not to choose for their little pranks. We are covering the most populated part of the district in snow. It's not like the whole thing is going to be completely winterized, but it's going to be a pain for people to clean up, which is always the fun part. That's what you guys get for costing me my alley. And you know what? I could try and get Polyphemus back for the little ocean monument right here, but I'm still not really sure about how to do that. Either way, I think it is time that we pay Code a visit as well. We need to make sure that his house is not only covered in cobwebs, but ice as well. So we're gonna use the good stuff in here. He's gonna have to change his name from Code MC to Cold MC. Haha, I'm so hilarious. So we have the big purple spire here and the big mega base for Rob. Now I would be focusing more on Code since he's the one who actually put the noisy business in my house, but I don't really know what he has besides his house. Where can we put these guys? Because he's got nether portals here, and I know they're going to wander in there eventually, so I don't know, maybe we'll go on the roof. Oh, never mind, we won't go on the roof. Here's what we can do. We have 4 left. We put each one on one of these ledges here, if we can fly up to all of them. There we go. Alright, so it's not really going to make a mess, but it's going to be funny for him to try and fix. So we have our little friends all hidden away in his mega base, and I think that's it for the snow, so we're just going to go back to the shopping district. And actually, you know what? I just remembered I have this nice bad omen effect on, so we are going to prank Code a little bit more. And we're gonna go straight to the villager trading hall, and we're just gonna step inside. There they are! There's my little revenge on Code. He can put up with these guys. Ooh, who's the pillager now? Apparently that guy is. Alright, well, Coat and Steercat can, have the rest of this. Just remember, Steercat, I gave you a stack of diamonds, so, that was payment in advance for impersonating you and sending a raid upon your village. But, yeah, the entire server's at war now, so have fun! Look at all these eager vindicators, just can't wait to get inside and see this beautiful trading hall. I might not be able to slay Code, but we'll see if these guys can. Alright, well, I think that's it for our little prank on the shopping district. Not directed at anyone in particular, but it is Code's server, so, yeah. You guys can have fun with this. Shout out to Evit for the wonderful snow shop that aided in my crimes. And, yeah, we'll just leave our snowmen to continue brightening up the town with their wonderful snow. And I'm going to casually go into hiding and try not to be the subject of revenge. And I will probably regret trying this, but I think I found a way to get Polyphemus into that lake after all. So we're going to take a bit of a ride over to the other side of this mushroom island, because there's a ruined portal over there that we found. And I think that if we can get him in there, we can row him to a portal on top of the ridge of the little donut area, and then just row him right on down in, and we should be good to go. Rob has found the prank, so he must be at spawn. Unfortunately for him, it's not quite over yet, so he'll have time to discover the true greatness of our scheme. So we're just gonna cover Polyphemus up here, make sure he can't get back out, and we're gonna make him jump through. There he goes! Alright, there he is. Where's the boat? Where's the boat? Maybe I can just chase him. I'll just chase him to spawn. And forget the boat. It's gonna be very deadly, though. He doesn't want to get in the boat. He doesn't want to get in the boat. Okay, I finally got him in the boat, as Ellie also discovered our prank, so we're just gonna row our way all the way back there and eventually get Polyphemus into his new home. Oh, look at that! Steercat's here too. There's gonna be quite the angry party at spawn. I see it, Polyphemus, I see it! The portals! At long last, we are going to deliver him to his new home. Alright, so we have blocked him into a portal. Get in there. Oh, he's in, he's in. Just have to get him to stay in. Alright, we just have to go straight forward, and we will be down inside the shopping district. So, through the trees we go. At long last, the mob master returns for more mob madness. Uh-oh, Steercat's on the map, I see her. Oh, well, this should be a fun surprise. Oh, and there's somebody flying over there, too. That's probably Ellie. Alright, well, there's our winter wonderland. And I think we should be able to get down there. Whee! Alright, yep. There's Ellie right over there. There's our snowmen causing more mayhem. Oh, they don't like Polyphemus. Luckily, they only throw snowballs, so we should be fine. Oh, no. Oh, no, we're stuck. Shoot. I'm probably gonna regret this, but I will chase you. I will chase you into your new lake. We're having a snowball fight in the shopping district, it looks like, and he's going the complete wrong way. What? Why did you jump over the boat? At least this is causing more snow. He's getting there. We're on flat land now. Just keep hitting him with the snowballs. Go, Snow Golem, go. He's almost there, he's almost there. Yes, the snowball hit him right in. Oh, no, don't sacrifice yourself like this. Oh no. Okay, well, we successfully got Polyphemus into the shopping district lake. So, he can now terrorize the shopping district. I think that this is the ultimate prankster move. Definitely something only I would do, but unfortunately we're losing snowmen in the process. But yeah, Polyphemus is now sinking into the depths. Hopefully he makes his way towards the monument. But yeah, now that all of that nonsense is taken care of, I think that we should be able to leave as Polyphemus chases us out of his new abode. This is the result of our chaos. I told you guys there would be some shenanigans. Alright everybody, so now that we're done pranking, I guess there's really only one thing left to talk about, and that is the mansion that I found last episode, which I have fully lit up. I moved the portal inside, and now we have a bit of a doorway in there. I haven't done anything with this place yet, but I'm definitely planning on turning it into somewhere that I can eventually live and hide out from all of the vengeful Olympians that will no doubt be coming after me after everything that I have pulled on them. But one thing that I found out was that across from the Dark Mansion is a very, very close mansion that is still full of Vindicators and Evokers. Haven't looted it yet. Might leave that for other people, maybe if they want to do some sort of community invasion or something, I don't know, but yeah. We have some opposition in the Dark Woods, but yeah, that's pretty much all I have for this area, so if you have any ideas for the mansion or even a name for that dog, let me know down in the comments below. That will be the end of this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed all of the various shenanigans, and I will see you all another day. Goodbye!